Conte to play up front for Hibs. Two other changes saw Kevin Thompson and Stephen Glass in from the start. Derek Riordan was fit enough only for a seat on the bench. Scott Brown was suspended. And in the news, Stephen Fletcher was left out. Stuart Dougal was the referee, and the best of the action with Mark Hatley alongside commentator Jock Brown.
Craig Gordon getting good distance, that's young Elliott. Not challenged for that ball. There's Mikkel Yunus outside him, measuring the pass. Clearance was made there by Smith, only as far as Nielsen. Acrobatic attempt by Hartley.
Some effort this. Ball, Nielsen coming out, just getting the ball from under his feet and just flicking the ball over his head.
Here's Thompson. Just intercepted by Webster. In comes Nielsen. That's good play by Nielsen. Hartley loves the situation, running at defenders. But he goes up, letting it up. He's a chance now for Hartz. He's got to go in this time. Hartz had the lead. It's Rudolf Skatcher who scored. Credit to Robbie Nielsen and the first place, and then Paul Hartley.
Hartley was found. Lovely ball up the inside there. Initially a good save. That man just getting in there. Skatchel get his first derby goal of his career. And that's what you would expect. Good follow-up play there. Skatchel initially involved. Just the keener of the two to get there. This is what you could say. The team that's just scored the goal is most vulnerable. This is where you need to concentrate.
Certainly plenty of threats in that area for Hibs. There's one of them, Caldwell! Bisley couldn't get a hold of that shot. And it's knocked away in the end by young Callum Elliott, back helping in defence.
Great save, great leap, just rebounded back to Bouzelin too quickly. Just got caught under his feet.
There's Bednar. He has Mikkel Yunus running the ball, played inside to him. There he goes. Quick and elusive. And that was from Elliott. Good covering play by Caldwell. Another chance almost created by Bednar. That's brilliant. A very good controlled attempt on goal.
Callum Elliott, yeah, great awareness there, back onto his feet. So the oncoming player.
Elliott. Brilliant. McAllister. Very ambitious attempt, and that was a good effort there by Mikkel Yunus.
There's the man on the height, trying anything at this particular moment.
Of defending for Hibs here. Angle ball, and it's a good one, and the keeper's in some trouble. And Presley almost cashing in there.
This is a good ball, and you've got to expect Mikalski to come and get this. He's a big, big goalkeeper. He should be coming through all of those bodies.
Well, the lay here, because Gary Caldwell was the player, actually, who was struck by his own goalkeeper, coming for that. But he has a tendency, Malkowski, to stay in that line, and when he came that time, he was just a shade late coming for it.
You've got to be coming for those, clearing everybody out of the way, big screaming shout, everybody know you're coming. That man on the ball at the moment, Hart, is the problem man for Hibs at the moment.
Well, excellent ball in, a chance for Presley. Eased under it, just a fraction there by Murphy. That might have made all the difference.
What a great delivery. Hartley into that area. Keeper can't come for that.
It's quite clear that Gary Caldwell can't continue. And Tony Mowbray's made the decision. The captain is going off. Well appreciated by Hibs supporters. Murphy's pass is a good one. This is Kevin Thompson. And Murphy goes down. He was tripped by Mikkel Yunus. No one spotted that among the officials. That's Conte with a chance. An excellent opportunity. Amadou Conte at the far post.
He should have done better there. It's a good flowing move from Hibs, the best they've had. It's a great ball hung up towards the far post. Conte should be coming in, screaming in there on McAllister, not the biggest guy.
Oskacil. Talented left foot, plus it comes to Fassi for Bednar. That's Mikkel Yunus. And a very good block again by Gary Smith. He really has got in the way of a number of good attempts.
Great delivering again, and the goalkeeper nowhere, coming, stopping. Mikkel Yunus there, another opportunity.
Short, corner kick. Clearly turning it. Very good ball in, there's a match, and it came off Whittaker. And once again, Hibs were exposed by a cross ball.
He got himself underneath the ball. Hibs had just peeled off.
I suspect, in a sense, Hibs might not be too distressed to elevate one down at this point in the game. Here's Stephen Glass. Struck it well. Certainly showing a lot of confidence.
I think Craig Hogan will be delighted that that's all he's got to deal with.
2 minutes of added time. I'm surprised it's perhaps not a little more than that. I suppose they're getting called up and said it was the only hold-up in play. It's Bednar. Next player down is David Murphy. Perhaps that's why that foul was committed, to allow Murphy time to recover.
Doesn't look a happy man at the moment.
Well, Tony Mowbray and Alan Creel, the fourth official, Stuart Dougal. Well, I'll tell you, Tony Mowbray is a slow man to that kind of anger. He's not a happy man at all. And he's going to be ordered to the stand, Mowbray. He has been ordered to the stand.
I think he's disappointed. I think he's seen the challenge from Bednar, from Murphy.
Back here with Hogg. All those crisp passes from defence into Bertrand. This is Murphy. Good run forward this time by Thompson. That's promising. There's Conte. He's not in too far. Best move of the match from Hibs, I would suggest.
Super ball. The first mistake from Craig Gordon here. That's on target. That's in the back of the net.
Such pass is a good one. Here's Murphy in a very promising position. It's a good cross. And a very disappointing header by Bertrand. He was in the clear there. The height was fine for the header.
Super play. Great ball out there from Stuart Murphy. Super ball in. And that is a very, very poor header indeed from Bertrand.
Come on, Kenny!
McAllister plays it long, looking again for Bednar. Hartley following it. Been given clear handball by Glass, and why I really don't know.
But Hart is always going to be the man that's going to try and get in there. The arms are coming together, a little push, just a slight little push there.
So it's Hart against Markowski. Deadly finish again. Hart's a 2-0 lead. The top of the league is beckoning.
Yeah, you won that man. The ball to speak on the spot for the penalty with that sort of record. He's deserved that goal. We say this came against the run of play. Hibs having the best spell. Keeper there nearly on the 6-yard line. Cool as you like. Keeper no chance.
Good turn of pace by Sproul. Excellent turn of pace. Wonderful play by Sproul. Needs to cut back now, and the recovery was made by Brellier.
Incredible pace there from the substitute. Thought he'd lost it there. Great piece of work across the defender. Can't tackle you there.
Hogg did well there against Simmons. It's Wallace. Now Hartley. McAllister forward for Skatchel. Good movement by Waller here, received that extremely well. The ball inside is not a bad one either. Ball breaks kindly now. There's the third from Stephen Simmons. The Hibs catastrophe in defence.
Taking all 3 points for Hearts. Can't see any way back for Hibs. A little break of the ball there, but how cool was that? A little 1-2 off the two Hibs defenders, and that is as cool as you'll get. No chance for the keeper.
Well, I remember Hearts led the table for a very long time, 20 years ago exactly, and lost the last day of the season. The catch, a shot! It was almost number four.
As they could find themselves on the end of a right good hiding. You don't want that this early into the season.
Indeed, could have been number four.
Such a good technique he's got. Hartley up and down, loads of action on the ball.
Space here for Mikkel Yunus. Oh, that's number four. Markovsky completely deceived. It's a gala day for Hearts.
Great awareness of a super game. It's just capped his day. Here you go, look, goalkeeper just too far away from that near post. Anticipating the cross and just whipped in the near post. The goalkeeper should never be beaten from there. And I think that sums his performance up today.
Well taken down by McFarlane for Presley, his heart plate. McFarlane again. All too easy now for Hearts. There's no more action though. The final whistle goes. Mark Venus goes to meet George Burley. He'll talk to Tony Mowbray also.